afternoon, good people. I've been on for a while like this outside due to our lockdown, shutdown, quarantine because of the coronavirus, COVID-19. So I just want to take a little bit of time to talk about how, despite the states or some of the places are opening up, issues around these coronavirus, COVID-19, and all those types of things that are happening, what's going on with those that are in power, who are in charge of finding some form of reasonable solution as to remedy this COVID-19. Just curious as to what it is that some of us are doing to make changes in our lives in regards to how we take care of ourselves, how we esteem one another, meaning our families and those that we care about, and also what other thought processes that make provisions towards, say, if for whatever reason we may come up against another pandemic or some form of maybe apocalyptic situation or things of that nature. Many of you are probably going to YouTube videos or looking at other things that could possibly help you in an instance where, hey, what am I going to do if I can't get to the store or I can't purchase the things that I need? I mean, many of us went and got a whole bunch of toilet paper, but aside from toilet paper, what is it that you're going to do to sustain you? Have you given any thoughts to somehow making sure that you can remain healthy, like fasting or changing your diet or doing things that will keep you from being subject to something that could make you ill or take you out of here completely? One of the things I think about and what I've been doing here lately is this is the time of year that we do start our garden. We plant things in the ground, we put things in little cups and pots and start to grow seedlings. I also, about a month ago, purchased 6 chicks, and of course for them to raise to become chickens, and I'm not going to have them to eat, but they lay eggs every day, so I will be having plenty of eggs. And maybe in an instance for someone who may need some, I'll have eggs available for you as well. The water that I use to put on my plants, I have 2 55-gallon rain barrels, which collects water. Ever since I've had them up, normally during the winter, I empty them, take them down, so that the water inside them won't expand and bust because they are plastic. This winter was pretty mild, so I never took them down. And because my chickens drink the water that I collected them, I was able to give them water out of them all winter long. Now, collecting water in rain barrels. This is something that I don't know if anybody ever thought of, or maybe even considered as to what would be a good purpose for the water that you collect in rain barrels. Well, if you go on Amazon, or even if you go to YouTube, you'll also find that there are ways that you can take that very water that you collect in your rain barrel and either take 2 buckets, invert it upside down and attach with a filter on the top and a bucket that collects the water on the bottom, to be able to collect water that's filtered from the rain barrels that you didn't even have to pay for. You could also have that water, say if necessary, something happens where you don't have the water that you need coming through your plumbing, piped through your house through a filtration system and into your waters as an alternative. You can, of course, configure the pipes where you can turn it on as a secondary water source, so that you can be able to have water you didn't have to pay for piped through your house that comes from rain that you collect in rain barrels. And my household is only three of us, so having 110 gallons of water inside a rain barrel and using it for whatever we use every day, need it be bathing, drinking, cooking, whatever the case may be, can have that. Now, speaking of pumping, you may want to think, well, what can I do to keep some form of electricity? Well, as you can see, it's a very nice day today. The sun is out and it is giving off UV rays, not only to the plant life that we have, but also to us, give us the necessary vitamin D to support the immune system that we have to be able to keep us healthy. That same light can be hit onto a solar panel that you can feed to a voltage regulator that's charging a battery or 3 to 6 batteries. And in doing so, those batteries can give you the power necessary through an inverter, changing DC current into AC current, keeping a pump pushing water out of your rain barrels into your house, so that you'll have water even if something happens to the water that is piped through your house from your water source. If you so indeed have, some folks have wells. I'm talking about the city water. You could also use that power anything else that you have, again, from the light source, the sun, going to the same system, so that you can have whatever is necessary in the event that you can no longer depend on what it is or the systems that provide you with the things that you pay for, like water and electricity, to be able to live and survive here in America. So, my encouragement to you is to take this time, take advantage of this opportunity to rethink some of the things that you have going on. Rethink the things that you've been taking for granted, even down to the very oxygen that you breathe. Make sure you get some plants inside your house. And be mindful that even though we do elect officials and we have a government that is not only designed to manage our everyday systems like our highways and our public safety and managing money to make sure that we have what we need to do whatever it is that we need in our daily lives, our medical, whatever it is, our education, everything that's going on, there's going to probably come a time, whether it's going to be for a short period of time or a long period of time, where you're going to have to do this on your own. So, my encouragement to you, hopefully take into consideration some of the things I stated. Maybe do whatever's necessary. I have tons of videos that I've done, hopefully to giving you an insight or some education on what it is that maybe you may be doing or those around you may be doing. Depends on whether you lead or follow. Hopefully you're a leader. And do what is necessary so that you won't have to suffer not only from a pandemic, but having your family suffer as a result because you depend on so many things that we have at our disposal that for a time or two may be taken away from you for whatever reason. So, Josh Coach, giving you some insights, some things on what it is that what's going on, or what it is that we can do to make some changes. Consideration that we've been through this, we're still going through this, we're not out of the woods yet, and be able to operate independent of those who we depend on to give us the things that we have, even though we're paying them and we also owe them. I hope that you enjoy this beautiful day, and continue to think about what you can do to make your life better, and hug and appreciate your family. Peace.